trato tuyo, corazón. Tú quieres que yo te dé la lámpara con el querosín.
O sea, tiene querosín.
Yo quiero que tú me cambies los ojos de corazón.
She's doing it for your eyes.
Oh, gracias.
Your eyes for her.
The lady at the store had it in for Trisha. Trisha thought the lady was laughing and giggling with her or whatever, but the lady actually, I think, you know, liked her in a sexual way. I wasn't impressed. I don't know what was going on with them. I wish their ding-a-lings got stuck on a vine or I don't know.
Yeah. I want that baby up there. I'll be done in a minute and I'll be out of you guys' hair.
In order for me to get the tarp, I had to destroy their whole shelter.
Do what you gotta do.
Not a problem.
You guys sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite. And no hard feelings. And I'll see you guys tomorrow, okay? Take care.
Bye-bye.
He's such a bitch. You know what? I can get loud, too. What the f***? I can get loud, too.
I don't want to argue with you. That's all.
Sandra, how sure are you that it's not you tonight?
Oh, I know it ain't me. The person that's going home today is the one that least expects it. It's the person that in the past couple of days has been given so many different stories that we don't know what the heck to believe. This person will be missed, but for the good of the tribe, this person has got to go home.
So Sandra, is it safe for me, based on what I'm hearing, to draw the conclusion that it is Sean or John tonight that is going home?
It is Sean or John that's going home tonight.
Who here is getting a free ride?
Let it be known that John wakes up at noon and then he goes under the bushes. He has this secret spot where he takes an additional nap. I have yet to see him wash a dish or even clean a fish.
Where's that snake motherfucker, John? I'll tell you what, can't nobody trust that bitch right there. I never trusted you from day one and you can't be trusted. Ladies, he cannot be trusted. He will backstab you in a heartbeat like he did everybody here. Every time a plan went down, you put it together.
Sandra, why are you looking? You know where they are.
How the f*** did I know?
Because you probably did it. You're the one screaming. Because
I'm screaming at him. I'm not talking to you. I was screaming at that motherfucker. And you know what? They're not coming to enjoy Rupert's fish. Screw that. So I got up to camp first, and I grabbed the bucket full of fish, and it was so damn heavy. And I trip on a vine, and I spill all the fish. And I started arguing with John to the point where it saved me because they never pointed the finger at me as to being the one dumping the fish.
Sandra, first move.
Fair plays, buddy.
Dan, take one step back.
I mean, I have about a million questions I'd like to know about my grandmother, but obviously some people don't give a f***, so Sandra's
It's not all about you all the time.
Right.
Burton and John decided to go off on a walk. And a lot of the times I sneak up just to hear what's going on. That's how I always have a working knowledge of what's going on, what's going to happen next. This time when I saw them getting ready to go, I went over to Tawana and I said, you got to come with me now.
She's like, I want you to hear what I think is going on, and you can be the judge versus listening to me.
The timing was perfect. It's better for her to hear with her own ears coming out of their mouths than for me to put things in her head and for her to have doubts. There's no doubts now. I still think that Burton is a bigger threat than John.
I agree.
Then we'll get John on the next shot because John is just like a girl. My plan right now is to start on the two water cans. I'm going to hide those. I'm going to hide the nets because they haven't used them in a long time.
Lord, give me the strength to make it through all of this.
I'm gonna hide the pickaxe, all the knives, all the machetes. I mean, little by little, they just won't even see it coming.
See you in 10 minutes.
I'm gonna hide the spear and all four masks. Therefore, they don't have a way to fish unless they're gonna go out there with their bare hands. I know I'm going down, but they're gonna feel it more than I am. Yes, they are.
I mean, I need you to swear. There's only one swear that I'll accept from you to believe you.
Okay, which one you swear?
Your two kids.
He was like, swear on your kids.
Well, let me see those fingers.
And then he said, let me see your hands. Because he didn't want me, I guess, to have my fingers crossed. How dumb is that?
I swear on my two kids that I'm with you guys until, what, the final plea?
So I said, I swear on my kids. And in my head and mumbling under my breath, I was like, I swear on my kids that I'm going to screw you and Burton. I really don't give a damn which one of the two goes as long as it ain't me.
In my head, I already had it planned. Okay, grab the torch, step in the right place. Because every time somebody's surprised and in shock, they're all over the damn place. Forgive me. No, you have to say something bad about me. Go ahead. I am actually surprised to be sitting here. But now that I am, I'm kind of glad. I think I'm a good person, regardless if I cussed you out or not. That's how I was feeling at the time.
The winner of Survivor Pro Idol.